Hello world, welcome back. In this video, I'll explain how to use SurvivalCraft electronics. One of the most important things are wires. You can place them on the floor, the walls and the ceiling. They'll even connect to the edges of two diagonally adjacent blocks. We can turn on a light bulb by connecting it to a switch using a wire. We can also turn on the lights of a Christmas tree. So now you can use electric lights in your buildings. Wires in SurvivalCraft don't lose power over distance, like Minecraft Redstone does. So this light bulb can be turned on from over here. Another thing we can use electricity for is to open and close doors. Instead of a button, we can use a pressure plate. Now the doors will open and close automatically. If, for example, we have two wires next to each other and we want to prevent them from connecting, we can use wires in different colors. If you somehow do want to connect them, you can use the plain wire. To connect a wire to a wall, we can use a wire through block, which is basically a block with a wire in it. So now we can control the lights from outside the building. We can also use them to hide my wires here. Now you can hardly see the wires anymore. You can also use electricity to activate or deactivate spiked planks. Activate dispensers. Wait, what's that? Or ignite detonators. Next up are signals. The battery gives us a good representation of all the possible signals that a wire can have. To edit components like the battery, you'll need to look towards it and then press the G key. Or when you're on mobile, press the edit button. The signals we've just looked at are digital, which means that they are binary. They can either be high or low, on or off, 0 or 1. Another kind of signal is the analog signal, which is the actual voltage of a wire. An analog signal in SurvivalCraft varies from 0 volts to 1.5 volts, with an increment of 0.1 volts. So in total there are only 16 of them. So the analog signals in SurvivalCraft aren't really analog. There are 16 of them, so they are actually hexadecimal. On a day-to-day basis, we use decimal numbers, which go from 0 to 9. Hexadecimal numbers go from 0 to 15. In Survivalcraft, all analog signals of 8 and higher are interpreted as high by digital components. So for example, you'll need at least a signal of 8 to be able to open a door using electricity. And displaying hexadecimal values on a 7-segment display, which is basically an alarm clock display, we can't use the values 10 to 15, so instead we use A to F. The light bulb can change its brightness depending on the activation signal. And the WAN LED and multicolored LED can change their color depending on the activation signal. Now let's talk about the sensors in this game. All sensors will output analog signals. The thermometer will output the ambient temperature. You can use it to detect fires in your buildings, or lava. The hygrometer will output the ambient humidity. The pressure plate will output the weight of the item or creature standing on it. This will always be a high signal. The motion detector will output the distance to the moving animal or player in a high signal. The photodiode measures the amount of light it receives. In my printer world, I used it to detect the length of a series of blocks. This is a very useful application. The target will produce a high signal when hit by an arrow. The signal strength depends on how close to the center the arrow hit the target. Just like the new target block Minecraft has. Now let's see if a dispenser with 192 arrows can get at least one bullseye. More arrows. He didn't get any bullseyes. The real-time clock will output the current in-game time with the first three outputs, and the date with the fourth output and the fifth output. The fifth output is at the back of this component. To access this connection, we'll need to place this component on a wire-through block. And finally, I'll explain the pistons. Pistons can push and pull up to 8 blocks. You can edit the piston to change its maximum extension and its movement speed. All pulling pistons have a variable pull count. There are 3 kinds of pistons. The normal piston, which can only push up to 8 blocks. The pulling piston, which can both push and pull up to 8 blocks. And the strict pulling piston, which will not pull more or less than the pull count. By using different analog signals, you can make pistons extend to a custom length. When we use a normal pulling piston to move another piston, it will return without the second piston. This happens because extended pistons cannot be moved. In this case, we'll need to use a strict pulling piston. And by the way, this is how the piston door works. So now that we've gained some knowledge about the electronics, it's time to upgrade the house. First, let's make a system room. Now that we have a system room, let's just make our own weather station. Now let's wire everything up to make a nice time and weather display. Part 2 we'll cover the advanced components SurvivalCraft has, and I'll also show you the other systems I added to this house. I hope you've learned something after watching this video. Like the video if you liked it, and if you like my videos, consider subscribing and hit the bell to get notified for every video I post.